Hello everybody, today we are going to solve some problems which are depend on the total surface area and curved surface area of cylinder. Okay, from that first problem is the radii of two right circular cylinder are in the ratio 2:3 and their heights are in the ratio 5:4. Calculate the ratio of their curved surface areas. Okay, there are two cylinders. So two different radii and heights are given. Okay, so we will see here two different cylinders are given whose curved surface areas are different. Okay, so here what is given, the radii of two right circular cylinders are in the ratio. Ratio is given 2:3. Means this radius is different and this radius is different. Okay, the ratio is given 2:3. So suppose we will take here first radius 2r and second radius we will take 3r. Okay, because ratio is given, so r variable we are using here. So 2r and 3r are the radius. Second thing is given, the heights are in the ratio 5:4. Okay, so this is the height of the cylinder. So height we will take, this is 5h and this is 4h, because ratio is given. So here we have taken variable h, so 5h and 4h. Okay, and finally they have told us calculate the ratio of their curved surface areas. Okay, so first we will take S1 is equal to CSA of first cylinder and S2 is equal to CSA of second cylinder. Okay, CSA means curved surface areas. Okay, so now first we will calculate S1. Okay, finally we have to calculate the ratio of their curved surface area. So first we will find out S1, then S2 and then a ratio. Okay, so S1 is equals to what? S1 is equals to 2 pi RH. Curved surface area we have to find out with the help of 2 pi RH. So is equals to 2 pi, I will keep as it is because ratio is there, we have to find out. So finally pi we can cancel. So 2 pi into its radius is 2R and height is 5H. So it will be 5 to the 10, 10 to the 20 pi RH, 20 pi RH unit square. Okay, so now this is S1, curved surface area of cylinder first. Now we will find out S2. S2 also same thing, 2 pi RH we need to use. So 2 into pi we will keep as it is. Radius is, radius of second cylinder is into 3R and height is 4H. Okay, so product of this is 4 3s are 12, 12 2s are 24 pi RH. Okay, so this is the curved surface area of first cylinder and this is curved surface area of second cylinder. Now we have to find out ratio of this curved surface areas of both the cylinders. So ratio we will find out, S1 upon S2 is equal to 20 pi RH divided by 24 pi RH. Okay, pi RH will be cancelled, this pi RH will be cancelled. So 20 and 24 we can divide by 4 because 4 is the SCF. So 4 5s are 20 and 4 6 are 24. Okay, so our required answer is 5:6. The required ratio which they are asking, calculate the ratio of their curved surface areas. So ratio is 5:6. Okay, everybody got it? See here two cylinders we have taken. Once again we will put a glance. Radius we have, ratio of radius and height was given. So we have taken 2R and 3R and here we have taken 5H and 4H. Okay, so curved surface area we use formula 2 pi RH. So in that 2 pi into 2R into 5H, so that product we got 20 pi RH. Same thing for S2, third surface area of second cylinder, that is 2 pi RH, 2 pi into 3R into 4H, so that is 24 pi RH. Okay, so finally we have to find out ratio of that, pi RH will be cancelled. So 4 5s are 20 and 4 6 are 24. So answer is 5:6. Okay, now we will see second problem. Okay. Okay, see our next problem is, a rectangular sheet of paper is 44 cm into 18 cm. Okay, rectangular sheet of paper is given, 44 cm into 18 cm. Okay, so is rolled along its length, is rolled along its length. When it will be rolled, that time you will get a cylinder. Is rolled along its length. Okay, and a cylinder is formed. you will get a cylinder. So here one thing we can see, the length of this rectangular sheet is 44 centimeter. Okay, so length of this rectangular sheet and circumference of this cylinder will be same. Okay, because this distance is constant. So here we can mention length of a rectangular sheet is equals to the circumference of circle. Okay, so circumference of circle will be 44 centimeter. Okay, if here we will not use this height which is given, then you will get radius. Okay, so length of rectangular sheet is 44 centimeter. So that 44 I am taking here, and circumference of the circle we denote by 2 pi r. Okay, so now 2 multiply by pi, value of pi is 22 by 7 multiply by the radius is r. Okay, is equal to 44 centimeter. So here you will get 44 is equal to 22 to the 44 upon 7 multiply by r. So r equals to what? 44 multiply by reciprocal of this 7 by 44. So 44, 44 will be cancelled. So the radius is equal to 7 centimeter. Okay, without using this given height also we can find out. Okay, if you want to use height, then you can do here, see, CSA, curved surface area of this rectangular sheet and curved surface area of this cylinder will be same. So that time we can use 18, means height. Okay, so then too you will get the same answer. Okay, so we will see now next problem. Okay, our next problem is the diameter of a roller 120 centimeter long is 84 centimeter. Okay, roller means what? This is a perfect example of roller. Okay, what is given here? The diameter of a roller 120 centimeter long. Long is given, means this way it is given, the roller long means we have to consider that is height of the cylinder. Okay, so I am taking here that roller, so that is 120 centimeter is long, so that is the height of the cylinder, 120 centimeter. Okay, is 84 centimeter. What is it? 84 centimeter is the diameter. 84 centimeter is the diameter. Okay, so d equals to 84 centimeter. So radius is equals to what? 84 divided by 2, so 42 centimeter radius we got. Okay, now if it takes 500 complete revolutions to level a playground, how many revolutions are given? 500 revolutions. Determine the cost of leveling it at the rate of 30 paise per square meter. Okay, so here we have to think about curved surface area. Why curved surface area? Because this is example of roller. Okay, only this part is going to touch to the ground. Okay, so we need to find out curved surface area. This part we are not going to think about, these two parts. Okay, so curved surface area we need to find out. Curved surface area means what? We will get area in one round. Area is covered in one round. Okay, so CSA of roller is equals to what? 2 pi rh. Okay, so 2 multiply by 22 by 7 into radius is, what is radius? 42 multiply by height is given, that is 120. So that will be curved surface area, centimeter square. Okay, so here 7, 6 are 42. 7 into 6, 7, 6 are 42. So here 22 into 6, 132 multiply by 122 are 240. So here 0 centimeter square is going to come. 24 2 are 48. 8 4 carry, 24 3 are 72 plus 4 76. 6 7 carry, 24 1 are 24 plus 7 31,680 centimeter square is the area which is covered in one round. Okay, like that, how many revolutions are there? 500 revolutions. So we need to find out total area which is covered in 500 revolutions. Okay, so here we will take area covered in 500 revolutions. 500 revolutions, that equals to 31,680 multiplied by 500. Okay, but if you will read this problem carefully, then you will get here, determine the cost of leveling it at the rate of 30 paise per square meter. Per square meter. These all things are given in centimeter, but here they are asking answer in meter. Okay, so we need to convert this centimeter square into meter square. So here we need to divide by 100 into 100. Centimeter square we are going to divide into meter square. So we need to divide by 100 into 100. Okay, so now we will solve this. 0, 2 zeros will be cancelled. This will be cancelled. So now what is going to remain? 31.6.8 multiplied by 5. Due to this 10, one decimal point you will get, and we need to multiply by 5. So 5 8s are 40, 0 4 carry, 5 6 are 30 plus 4, 34, 4 3 carry, 5 1s are 5 plus 3, 8, and 5 3s are 15. Okay, after one digit decimal point. Okay, so this is 1584 meter square. Okay, this is in meter square. 1584 meter square is the required area. Okay, now finally they have told us, they are asking one question. Determine the cost of leveling it at the rate of 30 paise per square meter. Okay, so the leveling cost is equals to what? Leveling cost is equals to this area which you got here, 1584 multiply by 30 paise. We need to convert into rupees. Okay, so 30 divided by 100. Okay, paise we need to convert into rupees, so you will get the proper amount. 0 will be cancelled. Now we need to multiply this 158.4 multiply by 3.